Hello and welcome back to Digital Assets Daily. Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, wherever you are in your corner of the world. How much XRP does former Ripple CTO have left after another dumping spree? That's the headline of the first article for tonight's video. So, trading at 56 cents with more than an 8% hike in price in the past 7 days, XRP has been gaining steam. So, such developments in the XRP market still have not prevented Ripple's former chief technology officer, Jed McCaleb, from selling his assets. In the past 2 weeks, McCaleb sold close to 127 million XRP from his taco stand wallet. So, according to the balance sheet of Jed McCaleb's, XRP seems that he is left now with 326,302,344.081823 XRP, according to press time. So, former SEC boss behind Ripple lawsuit hired by crypto hedge fund that holds Bitcoin and Ethereum. Former SEC Chairman Jay Clayton will advise an Alan Howard-backed hedge fund on cryptocurrencies. Pretty interesting that he had left the SEC and tossed out an allegation against Ripple's XRP and then went to work for an asset manager that focuses on cryptocurrencies, mainly Bitcoin and Ethereum. Very interesting. So the next article, SEC claims John Deaton wants to trade XRP despite lawsuit. John Deaton wants to trade XRP again despite lawsuits, and XRP holders have set to interfere in the Ripple SEC lawsuit sensation. According to the U.S. SEC Judge Jorge Tinerero, the XRP holder John Deaton wants to trade XRP despite its recent lawsuit. Earlier, Deaton predicted that XRP price will double if crypto exchanges allow its trading again. And about this, Deaton reportedly said that he is not among other investors who got their money lost amid the SEC lawsuit. He said, "If you don't consider the suppression in price due to the SEC filing, I've never even claimed to have lost money in XRP." Next up, Stellar XLM becomes the third most popular crypto asset on Coinbase. Stellar price gains and recent integration of Lumen has generated increased interest in the token. So there is now an increased shift from Stellar to Ripple, which is co-founded by Stellar's developer. Partnerships and integration of Stellar to other platforms like Travala has also increased the popularity. Stellar Lumen's XLM has become the third most popular cryptocurrency on Coinbase, the largest US-based cryptocurrency exchange, and a Stellar fan shared the news on Twitter from the latest Coinbase data recently. So with the integration, Travala, a crypto-based travel agency, is also the first merchant to integrate Binance Pay in its services. As a result, holders of the XLM token can benefit from the incorporation of Binance Pay on the platform. You can now use XLM to book 3 million plus travel products worldwide on Travala.com, the company tweeted. And we want to finish up with Vechain, Chile's ontology price analysis for the 29th of March. We're always interested to follow it vet and see where it is headed. Vechain formed a range after the bullish performance in recent weeks, and Chile saw massive swings in recent days, but long-term holders and traders would look for a climb past the 0.6 to signal another leg upward. Ontology formed a bullish pattern and was likely to move to 1.66 once more. So back to Vechain after a strong performance in March. VET was consolidating in a range whose boundaries lay at 0.08 and 0.093 marked in orange, and the deviations are outside the range. So the RSI was above neutral 50, but showed waning bullish momentum in recent days as the price approached the midpoint of the range and closing a trading session below the 0.087 mark, that is the midpoint of the range, and retesting it at resistance can be used to enter a scalp short trade targeting 0.08 to 0.076 as take profit. And at that point, a long position can be entered if the range holds. And guys, remember, this is not financial advice. It's for entertainment purposes only. So smash that subscribe. And I'm going to leave you with a final thought. You can't improve if you don't try. I want to say thank you to our VIP on Patreon, Surf and Gary Davidson, but also much love to each and every one of you. And we will catch you in the next one.